Next up, peeps.
So, as usual, just me here messing around my deck, changing things here and there, seeing what works and what doesn't. One thing I could say I definitely realized recently is I went 4 copies of Sylvan Scrying is great for getting drawn on turn 3, but at the same time, it's Sylvan Scrying that basically has to be turn 2, otherwise you are becoming turn 4 drawn. So, I put more copies of Ancient Stirrings back in, went down in the Serum Powders a little bit because, after all, we're not just playing Fortron and that's all. Yeah, let's see, how much? Oh, I've got 40 play points and 10 tickets. Alright, so 10 tickets. Let's go play some games. I'm gonna mute this at first because I'm eating right now, so I just woke up. But we will see how this goes. Let's see, I have EE here and Ratchet Bomb, along with Old Stone, so definitely packed with ways of destroying everything. You know, double all his dust. Alright, so let's go start it. Just have to say, I really don't think I should have fetched there because if my opponent's playing a Void Mirror and they drop it, I am royally screwed. But let's hope we draw into another green source, shall we? Or a forest, specifically. Or Cascading Cataract, so I guess we have a few options here and there. Metamorphos. Are they playing Storm? Ah, Stone on the entity. Huh, I guess that is this kind of stone thing, huh? Well, it looks like they are playing. Is this planeswalking? The Savant. The greatest of the greats. I'm debating between. Okay, let's see. Let's see. What can I do here? I can go Karn, Ensnaring Bridge. Nothing that's over 4 can attack me. And then the following turn, I see myself dumping my hand extremely fast. Okay, so dump my hand extremely fast. Or just destroy everything. Let's see what else I have. Typically when I'm playing this matchup, what I do here is I just go get Trinisphere. Or I can go Golos. But Golos cannot hit this turn. I'm gonna say board wiping first. Next turn be able to do more than one thing with Karn. Or at least guarantee Karn's safety is optimal, I think. Okay, I'm down 22 minutes. I know in a way that's a little bit of a waste of turn right there, it feels like. Expressive iteration. That card just sounds amazing every time I see it and read it. I feel like this is kind of funny because typically I think with their deck they want to cast as many spells, but in this case they're trying not to cast anything. Okay, I guess they can pass some things on so he can get one attack in. Unless he can bounce bridge, which I highly doubt. Oh wow, okay. So I think Trinisphere honestly would have made a difference, but Karn would still be dead, and I'll be getting attacked by two creatures instead of one. So I feel like we're still winning here. The one card I cannot cast, that's ironic. Let's go first. Fetch something. Cascading Cataracts. Get that out there. If we're gonna get things that are too high or a land, we could just fail. prevents my opponent from attacking next turn. Oh, land. I guess those are both 3/3s minimum, so I guess I could take it. Okay, let's see, what else do we want to do? That's 4, 5, 6 mana I have. Not really risk getting another card I can cast. Let's see, expressive iteration, what does it say? Okay. If it had said target player draws cards, I'd have been like, oh no. So it looks like we're gonna actually be able to cast the big boy because it's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. You know what? Let's just leave it to the big boy to win this game. We have no need to draw cards, period. I just realized one thing. Emrakul could not attack. At least not yet. But it still pretty much gives me a free turn, so I'm gonna cash in on that. They went ahead and conceded. They didn't, well, I guess maybe they knew I couldn't attack. They couldn't get damage in, so they just called it. Let's see what we would have drawn into next. Yeah, we're gonna get there. Okay, let's see. Relic is good. Ratchet Bomb, Old Stone. Let's put this big boy Emmy away, along with Jace, along with Dublin Season. Now we have 60 cards, Spyglass, Torpor Orb. I think Stormman makes them scry too after entering the field. But cybering just for that one card, I think it's a waste. I want to see if Forsaken Monument and Trading Post can be put in the deck. But I don't think so. If we code and cast away, go off, we still die. Forsaken Monument, I really, really, really want that card. Trading Post is better though. I think we just do this and call it good. But Forsaken Monument, I could see myself putting that in on turn 3 is the earliest I can cast it. So turn 4 I'm getting to life, but on turn 3 you're normally dead against burn. Or is it Prowess? Or whatever this is. This might also have the route again in there. Okay, I guess we'll just go with this. I know Trinity Spirit is going to be the main thing we're looking for here. Alright, let's go. Not surprised, the opponent was already ready. Ah, if only this had an expedition map. Alright, so this is a magnificent start, especially for this matchup. No Swift Spear. Ah, spoke too late. Alright, let's go with that, that. Downside here is they're getting a turn 3 before us, so we could honestly be dead regardless of what our hand looks like. Light up the stage, maybe? Ah, he just kept a turn 1 Swift Spear. Seems good. By the way, I'm here taking classes for my job at the same time, so I could guarantee that he cannot cast spells ever, or I could start getting life. Which one's more important? I think as soon as he sees I can gain life, he's just gonna quit. So let's do that route. Should have casted the expedition map first, so I only had to click one time. Okay, didn't scoop. Opponent's trying here, I can respect it. I must have a lot of burn spells in hand. Negative. Okay, alright, we got there. Alright, so next game.